Welcome to the .NET MAUI Date Picker Control Tutorial. The Syncfusion .NET MAUI Date Picker allows you to select a date from a list of dates easily. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add this control to a .NET MAUI project. I'll also show you how to customize the date picker's width and height, programmatically select a date, add a header and footer, and customize the date display format and the text on the validation buttons. Additionally, I will demonstrate how to restrict the selection of date items by using the minimum and maximum date properties. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application, then give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. Here, I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Next, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the date picker control into this application. I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Picker NuGet package. So, I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Picker package and select it to install in my project. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. Open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So, I open the AppSAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate it, refer to the instructions provided in the link in the description below. Next, navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI Picker namespace. Initialize the date picker control. Now let me run the application. Look here, the date picker is displayed and automatically selects the current date. You can also manually select a date from the picker. To customize the date picker UI, I load the date picker inside a border element. Then, set the height request to 400 and width request to 350. As you can see, the control is displayed within the border. To programmatically select a date, set the selected date property to an appropriate date in the month-day-year format. Check, the specified date has been selected. Next, I will show you how to customize the date picker display format. For example, if I want to display the date picker format as day, month name, and year, I set the format property to the appropriate value. Look here, the date picker display format is changed to day, month, and year. Now let me show you how to add a header and footer. To display a header, define the header view property. Then, add a picker header view element and set the text to select a date and the height to 40. Observe that the header is displayed at the top of the date picker. To display a footer, similarly define the footer view property. Then, add a picker footer view element. It offers built-in validation buttons such as the OK and Cancel. To show these buttons, set the height to 40. Looking here, the OK and Cancel buttons are displayed at the bottom of the date picker. To customize the validation button's text, set the OK button text to Yes. and Cancel button text to No. Now, you can see the OK button text change to Yes, and the Cancel button text change to No. Finally, I will show you how to restrict the selection of date items by using the minimum and maximum date properties in the date picker. This ensures that you cannot select dates beyond the specified minimum and maximum date range. For example, if you wish to enable booking a flight ticket within the upcoming 30 days, set the minimum date property to the current date and maximum date property to 7th January 2024. Before running the application, remove the selected date property. Check here. You can't select a date beyond the specified range. In this video, I have demonstrated how to create a .NET MAUI application and incorporate a Syncfusion date picker control. I showed you how to customize the date picker's width and height, programmatically select a date, add a header and footer, and customize the date display format and the text on the validation buttons. Additionally, I will demonstrate how to restrict the selection of date items by using the minimum and maximum date properties. To learn more about date picker features, check the documentation link in the description below. I have also included a link in the description to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.